Hey guys, in this After Effects tutorial, I'm gonna show you how you can make those cool looking gradient spheres that you see everywhere these days. We're gonna go through some simple techniques in After Effects that will really elevate the look of those spheres. So with that said, let's begin. So in After Effects, I created a composition 1080 by 1080p with 24 fps and 5 seconds long. I created a new solid with color somewhere between bright red and pink and added a circular mask to it. After that, I duplicated the layer and changed the color to a bright navy blue. Once that was done, I started playing with their position to get a nice uneven distribution. I added another solid in purple color as a background to create more variations. Once that was done, I created a null object and renamed it Rotation Controller. I parented the red and the blue layer to the null and added 2 full rotation, and that gives us this. I created an adjustment layer, renamed it blur and displacement, added a blur effect by going effect, blur and sharpen, and fast box blur. Changed the blur radius to 75 and iteration to 5. I added a turbulent displace effect by going effect, distort, turbulent displace. In the effect, I set the amount to 300, size to 150 and evolution to 1. Now if we take a ramp preview, we can see that the colors are blending into each other in a really cool organic way. After this, I created another solid with the color more going towards the red hue and named it Blender. And this solid will basically work as a midpoint color where the two solids are connected to each other. I added a mask and feather it and set the blending mode to overlay. Now you can see how it's blending those two colors. I played a bit more with the mask feathering, and this is what we get after the ramp preview. Now for the next part, we're gonna be adding an effect called polar coordinates. And it's an effect I feel like needs a bit more of an explanation. So here I have this new comp with two shape layers. One is a box, another one is a circle. If I select the box layer and go to effect, distort, polar coordinates, change the type of conversion to rectangular to polar and set the interpolation all the way to 100, it basically forces the rectangular shape to convert into a circular one. Now if I take the mask tool and started drawing different masks, because of this effect, the mask shapes will try to convert them into a circle and we will end up getting these cool looking shapes. If we do the same effect with the box layer, change the conversion from polar to rectangular, interpolation to 100, you can see it forces the circle to convert into a rectangle. And as previously mentioned, if we draw masks over them, it will force them to convert into rectangles and we'll end up getting these cool shapes. So with that explained, let's get back to the tutorial, shall we? Back in the tutorial, I created another solid and named it Artifact, added the polar coordinates effect, interpolation 100 and conversion from rectangular to polar, and started drawing masks and moving them around. Once I was happy with it, I changed their blending mode to add and play with their masks feathering to blend them better with the comp. I also animate the rotation of this layer and this is what we get. After this, I created another solid, named it Specular, added a mask and feathered it. I reposition it in the upper left side, change the blending mode to add and the opacity to 90%. Now if we do a ramp preview, we can see whenever the artifact is crossing this layer, we get this nice specular hotspot and that looks really great. I selected the build comp and dragged it over the create new composition button. Hit Ctrl K to change the comp name to circle. I added a mask and adjusted its radius till I was happy with it. I added an inner glow by right clicking on the layer, layer style, inner glow. Here I started playing with all the values of the inner glow to create a nice fall of color all around the edges. And once that was done, I added an outer glow with same layer style and started playing with the values to get a nice soft glow around the circle. And this is the final result. In the project file, I included 3 circles with different types of color combination. So open it up, go into each one of them and see how it was made. Experiment with your own colors and different displacement methods to truly customize it and make it your own. This project file is free, so make sure you download it from the description below and have fun with it. As always, if you like this tutorial, leave a like. Any questions you have regarding this tutorial, please comment down below. I would love to answer them all. Share it with more people so they can learn these techniques. And finally, subscribe to Motion Nerds for more tutorials like this. And I'll be seeing you guys in the next one. Bye.